Slack meets ChatGPT. Today, I'm exploring a free tool called Sidekick, an AI-powered Slackbot that serves as your professional business assistant. Integrations with Salesforce, Zendesk, Jira, and others. It also gives you free access to ChatGPT 4.0 directly from your Slack. You're gonna love this. I'm Phil Pallen, a brand strategist. Welcome to my channel where I promise practical advice to build your brand. Today I'm showing you Sidekick, which brings the power of ChatGPT 4.0 directly to Slack. Music to my ears. I spend a lot of my day in Slack. This is where I work as an agency. This has made my life so much more productive. I'm gonna show you how it works in a moment. I'm a big fan of GPT tools that already integrate with existing tools and platforms that we already use and love. Sidekick is exactly that. They are sponsoring this video, but I'm sharing it because I actually believe that you could benefit from using this. I certainly do. So let's take a closer look together. If you're like me, you spend a lot of time in Slack, and I'm loving now having Sidekick literally as my sidekick. So here under apps, you're gonna see your Sidekick channel. The concept of Sidekick is really simple. You can ask it questions in natural language to organize your apps, track important topics, set reminders, query documents, summarize conversations, and even direct messages in Slack. And we're gonna look at some of those examples today. I love how it's already helping me like an assistant might. It says, I know noticed you haven't replied to this message for 12 hours, just making sure you're on top of it. Sidekick was right. I absolutely forgot to reply to this message, and I love that Sidekick is helping me stay on top of it. And I'll give it feedback there so it knows what I like and how it can continue being helpful for me. So that's a way it's already been helpful for me before I even set anything up. I'm gonna navigate here over to the About page, and I love some of the examples that it gives you here, things I can do for you. Summaries, answering questions about what is happening in other apps that you use today. We'll look at Salesforce and Zendesk. Tracking interesting keywords. Answering questions about a spreadsheet. We'll look at that next. Reminding you about whatever you asked me to do. Or quick access to ChatGPT 4.0 directly from Slack without having to pay a separate fee for it. So after you register, which takes about 3 minutes tops, you'll start getting notifications when something interesting happens, just like the example that I showed you. I noticed you haven't replied to this. That alone has been really useful. Sidekick calls these cues, and you can tweak which cues you get to match your personal preferences with just a few clicks. No need to wait for IT. Let me show you some examples of Sidekick in action, reminders, summaries, and tracking. There are so many great ways to use Sidekick. Let's start with a really simple one that I actually use a lot. Reminders. So we could type something like, remind me in 1 minute to log out of Slack. Give it a few seconds to think, and then you'll have a reply. No worries, I'll remind you to do this at 1:14, which is in 1 minute. For the purpose of this video, I'll speed this up so you can see how it reminds you. And there we have it. Imagine a minute went by and you can see my reminder right here in my Sidekick channel. Let's try another one, a little more advanced. We're gonna summarize one of my existing Slack channels. So in this case, it is a client channel. And there we have it, a little summary of what has taken place in that Slack channel recently. I also love the ability to share this summary wherever I want, if I want, and if we want to give feedback to Sidekick, we can, which they appreciate. It helps them make the app even better. Now, let's say we wanted to track mentions of certain keywords in Slack, in Zendesk, Jira, or Salesforce. That's as simple as typing track. And then the keyword that you actually want to track. So in this case, I might say a brand name like Sony. Let's say they were my client. Just like that, Sidekick says, gotcha. I'll let you know when the keyword Sony is mentioned on Slack, Salesforce, or Zendesk. See how simple this is to be able to interact in plain English and not have to worry about crafting some kind of fancy formula, algorithm, or prompt. Sidekick has built-in mechanisms to make sure that you don't get overloaded, from automatic aggregations, breaks, deduplications, and the ability to stop or filter any cue with a few clicks. It has bi-directional communication with your apps so that once a cue becomes obsolete, it closes automatically, which keeps things clean and organized. Next, I want to show you how you can handle a spreadsheet with Sidekick. I'm going to use one in Google Sheets for this quick example. As we start to bring in other apps and tools, this is when things get very interesting. On the screen, I'm showing you just some sample data here in Google Sheets, okay? There's a lot of data here, so if I want some help to actually understand what's here, I can use Sidekick for that. Hopping back over to Slack, specifically in my Sidekick channel, I'm going to first drop the link to Sidekick. And there it says, okay, I've got your file, now ask me questions about it. Let's say I want it to show me a breakdown of employees per department. I will simply ask that. And have a look at this. Here's a breakdown of the number of employees per department. How awesome. Let's try another one. Oh, there's a reminder that I had set actually before recording this video. It is time to call my mom. I'm gonna do that after I finish this recording. Let's try, which department has the most women in it? And there we have it. The department with the most women is IT, 119 women. That is based on the data that I provided in the link. I want to try one more. What is the average salary of men versus women? Boom, there we have it. The average salary broken down by gender. Let's go back to our data here just to show you that there's a lot of stuff in here and just how smart this platform is to be able to extract this information. It's incredible. Seriously. Okay, now let's look at an integration with Salesforce, a popular CRM used by many businesses. Watch how Sidekick can interact with it without you even needing to leave Slack. Honestly, that's the best part. I don't have to go and count or do separate tasks in another window or tab in Salesforce. Instead, I can stay right in Slack and get the information I need. So let's try this. How many opportunities does Tomer have? Great, and I'll click enter. And there's my answer. Tomer has 64 opportunities in Salesforce. What about this? How many of those are over 150,000? Excellent. Tomer has 4 opportunities that are over 150,000. Let's try one more. Can you show them to me? Again, making it possible for me to get information that I need right now without having to leave Slack. I get this great little summary that I can also open in a new window with a single click, and I just love this format that makes it so easy to share or download if I want. Genius. That is Salesforce. Let's shift gears now and look at Zendesk, a very popular software for customer support. Zendesk, Jira, and other integrations will operate in a very similar way, but let's look at some examples. How many tickets do we have? We have almost 1,000 tickets in Zendesk. Let's try another one. How many of these are urgent? There are 4 tickets that are marked as urgent, and one more. Which agent is handling most of the urgent tickets? And there's our answer. Shai is handling the most urgent tickets with a total of 3. That's the Zendesk integration in action. Finally, I want to show you how you can benefit from free access to ChatGPT 4.0 by installing Sidekick for free. You don't have to pay the fee for ChatGPT 4.0 either. This is truly awesome. Okay, so in the Sidekick channel here in Slack, not having to go to a separate website to access ChatGPT 4.0, I'm going to type a prompt just like I would put into ChatGPT directly. If you've played around with ChatGPT, you're probably perfecting your prompt skills. I've certainly found that the more specific you are in the prompt, the better the result. So let's say, for example, I'm looking to generate blog post titles for a blog post that I want to write called Best Restaurants in Amsterdam. Here's the prompt that I'm going to write. You are an expert copywriter who writes catchy titles for blog posts. Write 10 catchy blog post titles with a hook for the topic Best Restaurants in Amsterdam. Here's where I get specific. The title should be written in the English language. The title should be less than 60 characters. The title should include the words from the topic Best Restaurants in Amsterdam. Do not use single quotes, double quotes, or any other enclosing characters. Do not self-reference. Do not explain what you are doing. There you go. How's that for specific? And there we have it. Some absolutely awesome options from ChatGPT 4.0 without first of all having to pay for it or even open a second browser tab. Save for the flavor, top 100 unmissable restaurants in Amsterdam. 10 amazing title options that followed exactly what I asked for. I'm so pleased that I can do this directly from Slack. So that is Sidekick by Jigso. It's incredibly powerful and customizable for your existing workflow. That's the best part. Say goodbye to 10 different dashboards, complex filters, fancy SQL queries. Communicate with Sidekick in plain English to ask it whatever you need. I am linking to Sidekick in the description below so you can check it out for yourself. They have a free plan, which means that you can try it and use it and integrate it into your workflow right away. If you've got any lingering questions, comment below. Let's keep the conversation going on down there. I respond to those personally. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a like. That helps other people discover these videos, which we work hard to create for you. And subscribe for more of my videos on branding, positioning, building, and promoting your brand. Next, I'm sharing a few videos I think you'll be interested in. I'm Phil Pallen. Thanks for watching. Those are coming up next.